Working on male reproduction and male infertility or fertility is not only contribute to improve male reproductive health, but certainly you can see it helps female reproduction because, you know, it is always working together. My lab studies ion channels and other signaling molecules in reproduction, trying to understand how they regulate processes in fertilization. CatSper is one of the ion channels specifically found in the tail of a sperm cells. Ion channels are key proteins in the cell membranes. They allow ions such as sodium, potassium, and calcium in and out of the cells. The activation of CatSper lets calcium in, and the calcium is required for switching motility pattern into more vigorous and whip-like motion that's necessary for efficiently navigate in the very viscous environment in the female reproductive tract and also penetrate the outer layer of the egg. Without proper activity of the CatSper, for example, human with a CatSper mutation, they are 100% male infertile. We use really a variety of methods ranging from human genetics to electrophysiology, biochemistry, and functional imaging of our live cells. One unique technology we routinely use is a super resolution microscopy because sperm cells are the smallest cells in the body. Using super resolution microscope that break the diffraction limit of light, you can have a spatial information of molecules in sperm tails. So we have a confocal and super resolution combination unit together with a live cell imaging setup. So it's heavily microscopy lab. By understanding CatSper function better and then finding ways to activate CatSper function actually help find a way to potentially treat male infertility. Many steps in fertility treatment are on females, regardless of whether the cause is a male or female factor. So reducing even one cycle of IVF by improving sperm function, even in vitro, it means a lot. Understanding CatSper channel is basically enhanced fundamental understanding of how ion channels work and also how calcium signaling works, which is like a broader implication in cell biology and beyond. So it's really rewarding that in this area of research, which I can have a basic science research and then have a potential translational application which can impact human society.